Good morning everyone. Today we'll discuss a problem on crystallinity of polymer. This question was asked in GATE 2013 and the question is the density and associated crystallinity for two polypropylene samples are as follows. Density is given in gram per centimeter cube and percentage crystallinity. Is here 1.4 density 1.2, it is 50%. For density 1.44, it is 80%. So the question here which is asked is, so density of totally amorphous polypropylene is, and the question B is the percentage crystallinity of polypropylene sample having a density of 1.3 gram per centimeter cube is. So first we'll discuss what is crystallinity in case of polymer. And we'll use the formula which is written over here. So you need to remember this formula. Percentage crystallinity is equal to rho s minus rho a divided by rho s whole divided by rho c minus rho a divided by rho c into 100. Here rho s is density of sample whose crystallinity is to be measured. Means you have been given a sample and that whose density is rho s, and you have to just tell what is the crystallinity. And rho a is equal to density of totally amorphous polymer, means the polymer which you are having. That polymer, if you consider it as totally amorphous, then what will be the density of that polymer? So that density is rho a, and rho c is equal to density of crystalline, and this is 100% crystalline, same as it was in amorphous. So same polymer when you consider it in 100% crystalline state. Now, crystallinity is somewhat related with crystallinity of metal. So we know polymer. Suppose we take case of polyethylene, like CH, these are the repeating unit. So here in case of polymer, we have got more number of atoms as a repeating unit. This is a repeating unit. It has got carbon, hydrogen, this basically forms a chain structure like this. So here to define crystallinity is a very difficult task. So as we have seen in case of metal, that we have got the atoms, single atoms which are arranged in a particular fashion, then we can clearly say what is the volume which is not occupied by atom and the volume occupied by atom, and we simply tell in terms of packing fraction and also the arrangement which is very irregular. But it is not so in the case of polymer. So to define crystallinity, we somehow consider like chain. We have got the chain structure, and in the chain structure, suppose this is the chain structure. If you get similar chain structure, then we can somehow draw a unit cell. We'll try to draw a unit cell and we'll say that yeah, this material is somewhat crystalline. But it is not so, because this is a very large chain, and to maintain crystallinity it is very difficult. So basically crystallinity of polymer depends on two factors. The first is the size of monomer. The monomer is the repeating unit. What is the size of this? Here we have got two carbon atom and four hydrogen atom. So it is basically a small size monomer. But in case of big size monomer, suppose we have got C17H34, something like this. Suppose this you consider as monomer. So this is a very bulkier monomer. So this bulkier monomer always does not want to crystalline when we cool the polymer from the liquid state. When you transform from liquid to solid, then it does not allow. So whenever the size of the repeating unit will increase, then the percentage crystallinity in the polymer will decrease. So percentage crystallinity will decrease. And the second factor is linear or branch polymer. Basically, when we have a linear polymer, a simple polymer, linear polymer looks like this, and the branch polymers look like this. So what happens when you try to cool the linear polymer? Then it easily arranges and forms a particular pattern. But in the case of branched polymer, it tries to arrange, but since these branches are there, so there will be another polymer also, monomer also. So these branches will collide with each other and they will try to hinder their arrangement. So that's why when we increase the branches, you can say the network polymer, which are very much network like this, then it will be very difficult to get a crystalline structure. So always you will find that a network polymer or a branch polymer will not have much crystallinity. They will be, I think, amorphous in most of the case. They may have some crystallinity in very small regions. So you need to remember is the size and the linearity or branched branches which is present in the monomer. Okay, now since you have understood this, so we'll get back to the question and we'll try to solve the question. The question was this. We have given density and crystallinity. So we'll use the formula, this one, and the solution is here. Percentage crystallinity equal to this. So first case it was given 50. So 50 is equal to 1.2 minus rho A divided by 1.2. all divided by rho c minus rho a by rho c into 100. Okay, and we can see here the denominator term rho c minus rho a by rho c. Rho c is for 100% crystalline and rho a is for 100% amorphous. So this value is a constant value. And the second equation will be 80 is equal to 1.44 minus rho a by 1.44 all divided by rho c minus rho a by rho c into 100. So here also the same term is there. So these two will be constant. The only variable is in the numerator. So what we will next do is we'll try to divide both equation. We'll divide 1 by 2 and see, because these two will be cancelled. 100 will be cancelled, this will be divided, and we will get this equation. 5 by 8 equal to this, 1.2 minus rho a into 1.44, 1.2 into 1.44 minus rho a. So on solving we will get rho A is equal to 0.94 gram per centimeter cube. And this is the answer. This is the answer of the first part, in which we were asked about the density of amorphous material. So density of totally amorphous polypropylene is, the answer was 0.94. so this is the correct answer. And the second question, we'll try to find for the density 1.3 gram per centimeter cube. So first we'll use the finding rho A is equal to this in equation 1. According to equation 1, 50 is equal to 1.2 minus rho A. So rho A will put as 0.94 divided by 1.2, and rho C minus 0.94 divided by rho C into 100. On solving, rho C is equal to 1.658. And next task is to use this rho C in the formula. Now suppose we will use this formula. Percentage crystallinity for rho S is equal to 1.3, then 1.3 minus 0.94 divided by 1.658 minus 0.94 divided by 1.568 into 100. This comes around 64%. And so the answer for the second part will be 64%. Hope you have understood about crystallinity. Thank you.